Sunday.
About to see. I was bombarded with messages from people asking me if my family was okay. I was confused, so then I called my sister. She picked up after the longest 5 seconds of my life. After making sure that my family was okay, I felt a sense of relief. But the confusion was still there. Still, I had no idea what was going on. I went back home, and like every other Lebanese living abroad, I turned on the news to see what was going on back home. The news headline was Beirut explosion. I immediately felt my heart sink, for how can two contradictory terms be in the same phrase? How can the beauty of Beirut be placed next to the horror of an explosion? I then painfully learned that at least 157 people were killed, 6,000 others were wounded, around 80 still missing, and 300,000 families now homeless. The Lebanese people had already been suffering from an economic crisis, a skyrocketing unemployment rate, and a terrible pandemic. Who thought things could get any worse? Beirut, the bride of the Middle East, you're now covered in debris and rubbles. But my sweet Beirut, you're still beautiful. History bears witness to your resilience. You always rise from the ashes. You will rise again and again, and we, ever so devoted to you, will never stop believing in you. My beautiful Beirut, did you see how your sons and daughters gathered up hand in hand to save you? Did you see how they ran to you with their shovels and their broomsticks to clean up the mess that was suffocating you? Unity and love of the Lebanese people, in their resilience, their faith, and their strength, to hold each other in the darkest moments. Isn't this what you've taught us? This stand today is first and foremost for the victims who lost their lives. It's for the families who are still looking for their loved ones with hope on their side. It's for those whose houses were destroyed, and it's for the thousands whose wounds are still healing. For every child whose childhood was tainted with trauma, for the firefighters, the healthcare workers, and the volunteers. It's for every mother, father, sister, brother, friend in Lebanon, whose lives will forever be marked with the tragedy that took place on August 4th at 6:07 p.m. We'll rise again, Beirut. Until then, I will always speak of you just like I always did, until I see you again. Join me in a moment of silence for the families and friends who are still living in terror and grieving the loss of their loved ones.
Bye.
There's also chalk in the middle if anyone would like to draw anything or write anything down. Also feel free to keep lighting candles. Just a quick update concerning the donations. If you didn't notice,
you might as well let it flow. Here, let it flow.